पुनः सर्वेभ्यो नमः. सो ऐ थिंक वैल इंट्रोड्यूसिंग शतावधानि आर गणेश जी, ऐ रिमेम्बर द ईडियम फ्रॉम चतुर्भाणी, और ऐ थिंक इट इज फ्रॉम पद्म प्रावृतक, किमिदं दिवादीप प्रज्वलनं क्रियते. सो दिने पुनः दीप प्रज्वालनेन किं प्रयोजनं यस्य तावत् स्वयं प्रकाशः. So I think we are running, means the time remaining also is very less. Therefore, I don't actually take too long time to introduce. And I know that Ganesh ji doesn't allow me if I go beyond 2 minutes. So therefore, I just want to say and few things like he has performed more than 1200 avadhanams, ashtavadhanams and 5 shatavadhanams. And he is a polyglot that he knows 18 languages. He converses in 18 languages. And especially in India, more than 10,000 followers are there. And many people actually benefited a lot with his lectures and books. That in Karnataka, whoever is from Karnataka amongst the participants, they must be knowing about this. So they are not simply blind followers or just because of some kind of bhakti. It is really Ganesha Varyanam Upanyasaha Punashta Pustakaniva Tebhyaha Yat Jnanam Praptam Vartate Tena Swajivanepi Yathava Bharatiya Samskriti Vishayepi Bahu Jnanam Praptavanta Santi Tena Te Krita Tannama Parishkara Santi Bahushu Vishayeshu Ahamapi Pratyaksha Rupena Paroksha Rupena Cha Bahubi Bahu Jnanam संप्राप्तवान् अस्मि तेभ्यः. पुनश्च अवधानकलायाः अत्र कर्णाटकभाषायाम् अवधानकलायाः पुनः तस्य पुनः सञ्जीवनेन ते लब्धप्रतिष्ठाः वर्तन्ते. कन्नडदल्लि अवधानकले इति द आर्ट् आफ् अवधान इन् कन्नड इति यत् पुस्तकं वर्तते, यः महाप्रबन्धः तैः प्रणीतः तेन डिलिट् पदवी अपि सम्प्राप्ता वर्तते हम्पी विश्वविद्यालयेन. पुनश्च भारतसर्वकारेण प्रदीयमानः युवविद्वद्भ्यः प्रदीयमानः बादरायणव्यासपुरस्कारः अपि एतैः संस्कृतप्राकृतयोः उभयोः भाषयोः कृतेन साहित्यकृतेन महता परिश्रमेण तं परिश्रमं पुरस्कृत्य भारतसर्वकारेण प्रदत्तो वर्तते सः पुरस्कारः. एवं नैकभाषाभिज्ञाः नैकशास्त्रविशारदाः गणेशवर्याः विशिष्य अवधानकलायां तेषां मनीषा अतीव सो वाट् एवर् वी आर् सीयिङ्ग् अवधानम् इन् कन्नड नौ आक्चुलि गणेश् जी आक्चुलि हेस् डन् अ लाट् आफ़् रिसर्च् वर्क् अण्ड् हि हेस् ट्रयिङ्ग् सेवरल् मोर् थिङ्ग्स् आल्सो. हि इस् आक्चुलि डूयिङ्ग् मेनि प्रयोगाः नूतनाः प्रयोगाः अपि क्रियमाणाः सन्ति. अतः वि आर् वेरि लकी टु हेव् him as a resource person for this entire workshop. On campus asmabhi kartum na shaktam, online kurvantasmaha evancha asmabhi saha resource person rupena aparaha api Shashikirana Varyaha vartate saha yuva yadyapi adhunika kshetre abhiyantra padavi sena samprapta taduttaram samskrite tatah purvam api samskrite samyak parishramyati sma idanim alankara shastre prapta आचार्यपदवीकः पुनश्च महान् परिश्रमः कृतः वर्तते. सोपि अग्रे उपन्यासान् करिष्यति. सो नौ ऐ रिक्वेस्ट् गणेश जी टु स्टार्ट् द सेशन्. वेल्कम् सर् अण्ड् ऐ रिक्वेस्ट् यु टु स्टार्ट् द सेशन्. ॐ
तत्सत्. वेल्कम्, स्वागतं सर्वेभ्यः स्वागतम्. इट् विल् बि वेरि वेरि इन्फार्मल् सेशन् and it's a very rewarding session for me personally. And at the outset, I want to take the blessings of Parama Pujya Shri Shri Advayanandendra Swami, Advayananda Swami ji, for his kind words are so heartening and encouraging, and he's always kind to me. And then once again I welcome all of you. I am unable to see you on the screen, however we know Aparoksha Pramana is very important in Vedanta, and Shruti Pramana is always there. More than Chakshurvai Satyam, it is Shruti Pramana. We depend more on sound and less on sight. And Avadhana is one such art meant for sound. With this, we shall go to it. It was very well said by Sri Ramakrishna Pajjatai ji that this workshop should promote and should kindle ideas in the hearts of the people who have come here, Shivarathinaha, so that they can apply this in their respective regional languages. In our tradition, since time immemorial, no language had any reservations against other. Coexistence was a wonderful feature and is a feature today also. Sanskrita Prakrityoho Bhedaeva Nasti. Even Sarve Kaviha, all poets are polyglots and polymaths as well. And hence, Sanskrita became bedrock for everything, let alone Shastra, even in Kavya, even in Kalas, like music, dance, sculpture, and so many other things. And even in other aspects of life, everywhere, Sanskrita became the common lingua franca of all of India and greater India as well. Extended India, we do see even today. In that sense, knowledge of Sanskrita and knowledge of Avadanam in Sanskrit will not only enrich this directly, this art in Sanskrit, but it will also enrich the respective regional languages. Irrespective of the language, with no exception, we have such a possibility, and which I had not thought about that as a byproduct of this workshop. And I'm very happy that Dr. Ramakrishna Pajjataya at the outset itself told about this possibility. Yes, we have to nurture our Desha Bhashas along with Sanskrit, then only Sanatana Dharma and our Indic values and our Bharatiya Prajna will become strong and more meaningful, and we become a united front. But now coming to this session, it has been titled as Introduction to Sanskrit Poetry. Sanskrit poetry in particular, and generally any poetry, especially of India. What are the main features of poetry? We have the definition of poetry, Shabdarthav Sahitav Kavyam. Sound and sense, form and content, they make the combination, the harmonious blend, and perfect synchrony, synchronization, perfect symmetry, and cooperation between form and content. That becomes the synthesis of form and content becomes poetry. That is what the definition has been given since the time of Bhamaha, and many scholars, including Anandavardhana, have spoken about that. Well, what are the causes of poetry? It is also discussed in our Alankara Shastra. Pratibha, Vyutpatti, and Abhyasa. Pratibha is inborn imaginative power. And then Vyutpatti is erudition. Erudition of many sorts. Erudition of the medium. Erudition is the medium. Medium, of course, is language. And there are many aspects of language. Especially when we are connecting with poetry, we should have good exposure to and command over the language. Means grammar. Grammar has another dimension called kosha, that is lexicography and vocabulary. Grammar will teach indirectly about vocabulary, but vocabulary directly will be getting through the koshas, through the books, dictionaries, and also from the world. And then meter, prosody, chandas. And of course, we do need many other inputs of various shastras, itihasa, purana, veda, agama. These are the various systems of learning, and also various shastras like Nyaya, Mimamsa, Vedanta, and many more, and even the kalas, Sangeeta, Sahitya, Nritya, Geeta, Chitra, Vadya, and many more. And that's why we have Chatusra Vidya, I already mentioned, four Vidya, fifth the Sahitya Vidya being added by Rajshekhara, and then 14 Vidyasthana, and then we have 18 Vidyasthana, Ashtadasha Vidyasthanani, four Vedas, six Vedangas, four Upavedas, and Itihasa, Dharma Shastra, Agama, Nyaya Vistara, that is Darshana, systems of philosophy, like that. And we have 64 arts as propounded by Vatsyayana in his Kama Sutra, and then 73 Vidyas in the Jain tradition, and 84 Vidyas as expounded in works like Lalita Vistara from the Buddhist lore. All are one and the same. Whether it is Jain or Buddhist or any other tradition, everything is basically rooted in the Sanatani tradition itself. And so we have many Vidyas. This expansive nature of the Vidyas again suggests that our heritage looked into minutest aspects of society, minutest aspect of knowledge, and various aspects of emotional and intellectual pursuits. So all these things put together, that becomes vipatti. And that's why Bhamaha says, Aho bharo mahantavehe. Alas, how much is the burden that a poet has to bear with? Natat chilpam, natat chastram, nasadhya, nasakala, nasav yogo, natat karma, natyasmin, yena drishyate. That's what Bharata says. In natya, in theatre, every art, every science, and every yoga, every synthetic aspect of learning is being seen, and nothing is unseen there. Something like Mahabharata. Idihaste tadanyatra, yene haste natat kuchite. And then abhyasa, a very, very important feature. Many people, they fail here because Pratibha is not in our hands. It's God's gift. It's Daivanugraha. Everyone will be blessed with one or the other aspects of Pratibha. But Yudpatti is hard-earned one. Pratibha is something like the ancestral property. And Vidpatti is our earning. And Abhyasa is constantly working towards these things, constantly using these two and working further. In that sense, investing this money, investing the money what we have, and then perpetuating our work so that it will be multiplied. This Abhyasa is very, very important. Abhyasa Sarani Vidya, Buddhi Karma Anusarani, it is said. Vidya is always after Abhyasa. And then, these three things, constantly we can enrich our imagination, because Vipatti and Abhyasa will trigger and burnish the aspect of Pratibha. Well, Sanskrit poetry, if we look into the, its holy tradition, everywhere we have profound illustrations of a rich Pratibha, Vipatti and Abhyasa working together and creating wonders. Our poets cannot be blamed for paucity of any of these. But in modern times, many poets may have Pratibha, but very few will be having Vyutpatti, and fewer people will be having Abhyasa. Sometimes without Pratibha, just by Abhyasa they may be going, but we see serious lack of Vyutpatti in modern times. But no poet of past had this lacuna. Hence, Sanskrit poetry's beauty is essentially in the judicious and intelligent way of employing Vipatti, which is rotted well with Abhyasa, for the perpetuation of Pratibha. For Pratibha, I shall give few examples so that we can understand how erudition of various aspects will come into picture. I shall give the examples and explain in brief. For example, erudition in grammar is very essential for versification. Of course, prosody is always there and grammar is there. Mere grammarian cannot become good poet. That has been very well told by people like Kshemendra and others. But it has to be employed in a creative way. A very popular work like Niti Shataka of Vritrahari has one verse. It is describing the flights of a bee which is captured in a lotus. We all know bees will go into the lotus just to have the honey in that. And when the lotus closes after sunset, it is again Kavisamaya. One of the aspects of erudition is one should know Kavisamaya. Kavisamaya means poetic convention. It can be treated as meta-language. A collective agreement in an artistic way, so that this agreement can be constructively used. Something like mythology, which is used for all purpose, which is used for philosophy, which is used for religion, which is used for our temple architecture and so many such things. It is something like a mythology, something like convention that we have for poets. Like when sun rises, lotus bloom, and when sun sets, lotus close, and lily opens its petals when moon rises. And when sun rises, lily is closed, like that. But by this mere information, we have no beauty. Judiciously implied, aesthetically implied in poetry. So, Bhartarini says about the plight of a bee, which has been entrapped in a lotus. रात्रिर्गमिष्यति भविष्यति सुप्रभातम् भस्वानुदिश्यति हसिष्यति पंकजश्रीः इत्थं विचिन्तयति पोषगते द्विरेफे हा हन्त हन्त नलिनीं गजबुज्जहार. Oh, it says, the bee which is entrapped in a lotus will be thinking something like this. Oh, the night will end by itself because it has to end. Not till gamishyati. So affirmatively it is saying gamishyati. Tarunglakara for bhavishyatkala. Not till gamishyati. Alert lakara. And bhavishyati suprabhatam. It's not just prabhata. It is suprabhata. It's not mere morning. It's good morning. Bhavishyati suprabhatam. Good morning is bound to happen. Bhavishyati suprabhatam. Bhasvan udeshyati. The sun is suddenly going to rise. Udeshyati again. Here you see one laghu and one guru. Udeshyati. Bhavishyati. Gamishyati. Udeshyati. This way of using the words, it gives a wonderful leap. Nananana, nananana, tadhintaka, tadhintaka, tadhintaka. Means so much of spirit and so much of jubilance is seen. Ratir gamishyati, bhavishyati suprabhatam. Here you see, ratri is two-lettered word, very sharp word. Ratri, very small thing, ratir gamishyati. Suprabhatam, very long one, double the size of ratri. Ratri gamishyati bhavishyati suprabhatam. And bhasvan, just see the alliterating sounds of bha, the labial sound, the stressed one. Ratri gamishyati bhavishyati suprabhatam bhasvan. We have to pronounce this with fully closed and open mouth. Bhavishyati suprabhatam bhasvan udeshyati. Means so much of promise is seen here. Bhasvan Deshyati. And not just the lotus blooms. The glory of lotus itself is blooming. Hasishyati Pankajashrihi. And here the Lakshana Vatti idiomatic usage is very, very important. A very suggestive one. It has a beautiful Guni also. It can also be called as Guni Bhuta Vyengya. Hasishyati Pankajashrihi. Not Vikasati. It is Hasishyati. Hasishyati Pankaj. Here again, Hasishyati Nananana. Hasishyati Pankajashrihi. Ittham. So, Vichintayati Koshagate Direte. In Sanskrit grammar, we have a beautiful feature called Sati Saptami. Something connected with present continuous tense in a very unique way. Ittham Vichintayati Sati Koshagate Direte. So, when it was still thinking, which was entrapped in the flower, when it was still thinking, ha, alas, hanta, hanta, nalini, such a tender flower and such a tender creeper, nalini, it means both flower and the creeper, lotus creeper, nalini, gaja, bujjahara. Here you see the syllable, ha, it has to be pronounced with greater effort, ha, hanta, hanta, alas, alas. Vipsayam virupti, the repetition of words to emphasize ha hanta hanta ala ala nalini, such a tender thing, tender creation, gaja ujjahara. E ujjahara, jahara is litlakara. It means long, long ago it has happened. Paroksha bhutakara. When it was still thinking, what happened? Long ago, it was already pulled and crushed by a wild elephant in rut. Gaja Ujjahar. There, the Sayukta Aksharas, Vitva Aksharas, Gaja Ujjahar, 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 it plucked out and it crushed. Here you see this usage of the Bhavishyat Kala, Sati Saptami, and then the Bhuta Kala, that is Paroksha Bhuta Kala. All these have enriched the beauty, the Vyanjaka Samagni, embellishing features, and so beautiful, and it is very impressive and effective of the highest effect of the highest order is brought out here. And this whole verse is composed in one meter called Vasanta Tilaka. Vasanta Tilaka is a very, very swift meter without any pause in the lines. Padamadhyayati, Sesura, as we call in English. It means at one stroke, when it was thinking all that Tatirga Vishyati Bhavishyati Suprabhatam Bhasvam Deshyati Hatishyati Pankajashrihi Ittam Vichintayati Kosha Gate Virepe Ha Hanta Hanta Nalinindaja Ujjahara. It means it has happened within a fraction of a second, without any lapse, without any gap, it has all happened. This way of effective usage of language, one of the aspects of that is in grammar and idiom, a very, very important thing, vacho yukti. So grammar becomes such a wonderful tool, and it's a primary tool, and at the same time, judicious employment of grammar, application of grammar can create such marvels. And then meter, chandas, has also come to vital role. And then one more verse from Bhartrahari to show how contrast can be developed, how contrast and words, mere sounds, they can mean so much. Again from Bhartrahari's Niti Shataka, that is Mana Shaudhya Padhati, a lion, when it is bold, when it is weak, when it is meek, when it is hungry, when it is unhealthy, even in that condition, it will not graze grass. It will not live upon grass. It will not be nurtured by grass. It will only wait for its food. Its food, what is that food? It has the benefit of, it has the luxury of killing an elephant, wild elephant, and relishing the flesh of the temple region. How it was earlier, a lion in its youthful condition, intact, and how it is now, this contrast has been depicted so well by Bhartrahari. It is in the meter Shardula Vipridita, a very powerful, majestic, mighty meter, majestic, mighty meter. Kshutkshamopi, jarakrashopi, shithilam, shithilaprayopi, kashtam, dasham, apannopi, vipanna, vidhitirapi, praneshu, munchatsvapi, matte bhindra vibhinna kumbhapishita grasaika baddhastraha, kim jirnam pranamatte, manamhatam, agresar, kesari. See, api, even then, kshutkshamopi, even then it is hungry, jarakrashopi, when it is lean and weak because of old age, shithila prayopi, when all its vital organs are weak and they are disjointed, shithila prayopi, kashtam dasham apannopi, even when it has attained a very difficult condition, vipanna didhidrapi, when its earlier brilliance has been lost, vipanna didhidrapi, praneshu munchatsvapi, when the pancha pranas are about to live, here Satsakthani is there. Praneshu munchatsvapi. Here's the six times he has used all without samasa. Chutkshamopi, jarakrashopi, shithilaprayopi, kashtam, dasham, apannopi, vipanna didhitrapi, praneshu munchatsvapi. In such critical conditions, like Abhimanyu being entangled by the wily Shadrathikas, so our Simha lion has been troubled by six difficult conditions. How it was earlier? In one samasa, he reinforces that. Matte bhendra vibhinna kumbhapishita grasaika baddhas praha. You cannot loosen it. You cannot pause it. You have to pronounce it without taking breath. At one breath, you have to pronounce it. It means it was so intact, so strong, and every organ was so copious. Matte bhendra vibhinna kumbhapishita grasaika baddhas praha. Here the labials, vashtyavarna, matte bhendra vibhinna kumbhapishita grasaika baddhas praha. When we relish food, we chew it the same manner, in the similar manner. We have to chew, we have to ruminate this thing. Matte bhendra vibhinna kumbhapishita. This line itself shows how it used to relish that matte bhendra vibhinna, the flesh of the temple regions of an elephant in rat. Kim jirnam trinamatti. Again, the concluding line, you see, kim jirnam trinamatti. Will it feed on grass? Will it feed on fodder? Kim jirnam trinamatti. Why? mana mahatam agresar kesari. This ekara, you see, whenever we want to call a person at a distance, who is at a distance, when you have liberty, hey, come here like that, hey, easy. Not ah, e. E goes upwards. It is raised. Mana mahatam agresar kesari. Like that, this lion was mana mahatam agresara, best among the people of self-esteem, a proud person, a person of valor. Yes. Such a person, such a thing, such an existence, this lion, kim jiranam krinamati. Here, I don't have time, otherwise I would have shown Riti, Guna, Vakrata, Dhani, Alankara, Rasa, all features are available. In one verse, all alone, Alankarika, starting from Amaha to Jagannatha and others. Everyone would take this verse and elaborate its beauty and its suggestivity and others. Here we have, this is Anyokti, allegorical way of expressing things. And also it deals with Vyatireka, contrast has been brought out. And we have Panchali Shaili. In the third line, we have Gaudi Shaili. In the fourth line, we have Vaidarbha Shaili. In so many ways, all these styles and even the Ojas, Prasada, Madhurya, all Gunas, mainly Ojas is seen here. And Vakrata is always there. This is Kavi Prabhukti. That way, so many features are there. I am saying, we have tissue culture. Even a small cell, a minute cell from the body of an animal or plant that can generate the whole body like that. One isolated verse from Sanskrit can reveal the complete beauty of Sanskrit and its literary traditions. This way of faithfulness to the profound and varied integral tradition is the beauty of Sanskrit poetry, and also the beauty of poetries of other languages of India who are nurtured by Sanskrit. You can see the same thing in classical Kannada, classical Telugu, classical Marathi, classical Malayalam, so many other languages. And then in our Sanskrit poetic traditions, we do have so much of emphasis on mythology, Purana. We should not call it mythology, we have to call it Purana itself. Puranavamiti Purana, the ever new world, that is Purana. How that can be used, effectively used? One didactic poem, Niti Padyam, it goes like this. Udarka siddhi vichyadhi saddhir nakalu drishyate chaturthi chandralekheva parastri dhalapattikaha. People who want to come up in their lives, they should not stare at the faces of other women. They should keep themselves within the frames of social decency, etiquette and morality. And that has been beautifully suggested. Udarka siddhi nichyadhi saddhi. Good people who want to come up in life, who want to progress well, nakalu drishyate, they would never venture to see, stare at the faces of parastri bhalapattika, the foreheads. Means unless we turn above, we look at them, we stare at them, their foreheads will not be visible. Forehead, they implies the face. But why he has taken forehead? Because forehead looks like crescent moon. You can clearly see on my face. And parastri bhalapattika, generally the forehead is compared to present of moon, a digit of moon, usually the Ashtami Chandralekha, and here it has been Chaturthi Chandralekha. Shankar Bhagavatpada in Saundar Lahari says, your face represents a complete moon, like that. Then again he uses the imagery. Well, coming to this verse, looking at the digit, fourth digit of moon in the waxing period of moon, in Shukla Paksha, looking at the fourth digit of moon, is not auspicious. We are going to approach, we are going to celebrate Varasiddhi Vinayakotsava in the next month. Bhadrapada Shukla Chaturthi is one occasion on that day, because moon has been cursed by Ganapati and Ambika. He should not be seen. When we see, we get apavada, we get bad name. People will gossip about us. So we should not venture for such disaster. And that's why this Pauranika Katha, Samantakopakhyana, as we know from the Varasiddhivinayaka Mahatmya, That story has been used. It is well known in Mudgala Purana and even Ganesha Purana and even in Bhavishya Purana, between the conversation between Yudhishthira and Sri Krishna. The story is narrated, and how Purana will have its share of contribution towards enriching a poem, that can be seen here in Sanskrit poetry, which is rich with this. And that's why if you look into the poetry of Bana, magnificent poetry of Bana Bhatta, it is so hard for a Westerner who is not initiated into the mythological details of Sanatana Dharma, he would find it very hard. But we people, we don't find it much difficult. Bana Bhatta has no difficult verbal forms. He will not use too obscure noun forms also. Rarely he uses, especially in Harshacharita, but not in Kadambari. But he alludes to so many mythological stories and anecdotes. We have learnt all these things even before we learnt how to read and how to write. On the laps of our grandparents, we learnt all these things. By looking at all the Yakshagana and all the Harikatha style, we read that Katha Kalakshepa, Katha Kirtan, Pravachana and others, we learnt. That's how Indian mythology is going to contribute. And also, Sanskrit poets have a very, very keen ear for music, verbal music. Very great scholar and a very sympathetic critic of Indian culture, critic in the positive sense, I am an exponent of Indian culture, Dr. Daniel H. Chingles, Dr. Daniel H. Chingles, D.H. Chingles, he writes the difficulty of translating Sanskrit poetry. There is a no other language can boast this much of lyrical beauty coupled with verbal music. Sanskrit prosody and even Sanskrit wording, Sanskrit phraseology, all these contribute much towards this. One stray verse on Krishna. Neetam yadi navaneetam, neetam neetam kimetena, atapatapita bhumau, madhava madhava madhava. Yashoda is pleading. Yashoda is requesting Krishna, because child Krishna is running away from her hands. She is not bothered about that. Has already stolen butter. Makanto churaya. Still, she is not bothered about that. Only the botheration of her is only regarding this. This boy is going and running in the backyard or the courtyard, front yard. But it is scorching summer. The whole ground is hot. So this tender feet Krishna, when he moves around that, will those lotus-like feet, will they not get burnt? Will they not get troubled? This is what her concern is. Neetam yadi navaneetam. If you are going to snatch away the butter, fell. Neetam, neetam, kide tena. Well, it will be so. I don't bother about that. Gone is gone. But atapatapita bhumo, the front yard or backyard, atapatapita, it is hot because of sun's heat. Atapatapita bhumo madhava. Oh Krishna, madhava, madhava. Don't ever run, don't ever run. The repetition again with concern, with sayam, vritti. This is in meter Arya. Neetam yadinava neetam. Neetam yadinava neetam. Neetam neetam kimetena. Atapatapita bhumau. Madhava madhava madhava. Atapatapita bhumau. Madhava madhava madhava. It can listen to Rupak Tala or Adi Tala, South Indian music, Ek Tala or Teen Tala, North Indian music also very easily. Here you see the Sanyukta Aksharas are very, very fluent. Neetam yadi nava neetam, neetam neetam kimetena, atapa tapita bhumu, madhava 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 nil. Means it is such a unchecked flow of sound, unchecked flow of melody, which can be felt. And even such a sound can suggest civility also. Sound suggesting thought, sound suggesting idea is very peculiar, and Sanskrit poets are masters of that. One verse from Jagannath Pandita. Tire karunya vadanam sahasam nire sarojasya milad vikasam alokya dhavat युभयत्र मुग्धा वरंद लुब्धा लिकिशोर माला. Here, on lotus pond, a lotus is fully blossomed, fully bloomed lotus is seen. By the side of that, a beautiful lady is standing. She is smiling and looking at the flower which is bloomed, and also smiling lady, the bees, young bees, who have not much knowledge of women or the world, they are unable to know where to go and where to fetch their honey. Tire tarumya vadanam sahasam, on the banks, on the by the shore, by the lakeside, a woman is smiling. Vadanam sahasam, tire sahasam, nire sarojasya milad vikasam, nire in the water, sarojasya the lotus milad vikasam, it's bloomed. Nire sarojasya milad vikasam. You see, tire, nire, vikasam, sahasam. In that way, it has similar sounds, adiprasa and antiprasa. Alokya dhavat yubhayatra mugdha. Having seen on either sides, it is unable to make a decision. It is perplexed. Maranda lubdha likishora mala. Not one bee, string of bees. Maranda lubdha likishora mala. Because not only the sight, drishya, is similar, even the shravya is also similar. This sound and sight, both are similar, and that's how the suggestion, this is Bhrantimad Alankara, an image which is developed because of Bhranti, because of illusion, and it is having a Gamya Rupak, Gamya Upama. Upama Dhvani is there. The face resembles the water, that is the Alankara Dhvani, and here Alankara Dhvani is there, Adhyanta Prasa is there, and mainly the Bhrantimad Alankara. In that way, so many are allied, so many are put together, and the beauty is established. Well, there are many more examples, but I have to restrict because of the paucity of time. I told about Vyutpatti. One most important aspect of Vyutpatti is Alankara Shastra Vyutpatti. Because Vyakarana Shastra is an independent science. Purana is another independent science. But for a poet, Alankara Shastra is very, very important. It is his home ground. It is Swashastra. To a poet, which is Swashastra, it is Alankara Shastra. Alambhavo hi Alankara. The feel of fulfilling, the feel of contentment, the feel of saturation is what we need in Alankara. That is Alankara, Alambhava, Paryapti Bhava. That feel of saturation, this is perfect, nothing more is needed. If anything is done, it will be overdoing and not at all desirable. To that extent, a poet should polish the verses. That's how they have the concept of Alankara Shastra. It deals with various aspects of poetic embellishment, poetic beauty, and other things. But we have all these things put together and called as Kavi Shiksha. How poets are being trained, or training of a poet. Kshemendra's Kavikantha Bharana and many other works are there. For example, Alankara Shekhara, Keshav Mishra is there, and even Amarchandra Suri's Kavya Kalpalata is there, and then Rajshekhara's Kavya Mimamsa. These are all several well-known treatises which aid a lot for making a good poet. Though it is said poets are born, but poets have to be nurtured, and they should be educated, and they should be there should be an upbringing, there should be a mechanism of upbringing. An infant, a baby, will not do anything. It is helpless in all respects. So poets may be born, but Mahakavis have to be made. A mere Kavi is born, but a great Kavi has to be made. We have two aspects of poetry. One is Griha Kavitva, and other is Sabha Kavitva. Griha Kavitva means leisurely composing at our convenience. So we are left with our time, our privacy, writing material, reference material, every book. Nowadays we have internet for anything we can search. Any dhatu, any kridantarupa, any tigantarupa, anything and everything can be searched, even synonyms and even the prosody, the structure, the lakshana of that. And if you need any other information, Google is there. Google Devaya Namaha, everyone can get. Like that, it is convenient. And we can also consult scholars, get the things corrected. So Grahakavitva has no restriction, no bar. But Sabhakavitva is not. It is something like delivering everything in public. We are left with avradas. No book, no scholarly aid, no internet, no Google, nothing. We have to depend on our own selves. As Mallinatha says, Sarvajna Bhupala Vilokanartham Vaidushyamekam Dusham Sahayam. When Mallinatha was going to visit Sarvajna Simha Bhupala, a king of Andhra Pradesh from Rajaviru, one person said, how come you are going like this? You don't have a gaudy attire. You don't have good costume. Don't even have a beautiful walking stick. All these things are essential to take an appointment with the king. What is it? Kim vasasa chikiri bakirena, kim dharana vankari tinkarena, sarvajna bhupala vilokanartham vaidushyamekam dusham sahayam. Our erudition is only one thing. That's what our Kerala poet Damodara said, Natchatram na turangamo na vadatam vrindani no vandina, mashmashroni na pattabandavatanam na yambaradambaram, atyasmatam amanda mandaragiri prodhuta dugdodadi, rinkat vichi parampara puranata vanitu naniyati. I don't have a mustache, I don't have a turban, I don't have a gaudy attire, I don't have a chatra, a white umbrella, I don't have even chamara, the fans, royal insignia, everything. I don't have anything. But I have only one thing. Spurging poetic skill. They are comparable to the upsurge of the waves of Kshira Sagara when that was about to be churned to get the ambrosia, to get the amrita, to get that amrita. The demons and gods, they joined together and they started churning. How during the churn the mountain would have revolved, and because of that how the mighty waves would have rose. Such is my versification. In that way, ekaika alambana, that is vagdevata, nothing else. This is sapha kavitva. And I conclude this session with one verse, a very very beautiful poem, a stray verse quoted by very great scholar Dr. Hajari Prasad Dwivedi in Prachin Bharatiya Kalatmak Vinod. In that book, he says, it's a very beautiful verse with the double entry pun. How a newly married bride, newly married girl would feel in front of his beloved, in front of her own husband. She's unable to talk to him. She's unable to advance. Such is her difficulty. It's a pastime glory. Nowadays, girls may not be so coyish. And also, the words of a poet who is not trained to become a sabhakavi, because it's very easy to, comparatively, it is easier to write at our free will, at our free time. But to compose extempore poetry, ashukavitva, that is sabhakavitva, is very difficult. The verse goes like this. नाहूतापि पुरः पदं रचयति प्राप्तोपकण्ठं हठात् पृष्टाप्नप्रविभक्तिकम्पमयते स्तम्भं समालम्बते वैवर्ण्यं स्वरभङ्गमञ्चति बलान् मन्दाक्षमन्दानना कष्टं भो प्रतिभावतोऽप्यभिसभं वाणी नवोढायते. Such verse can only be composed in Sanskrit and Sanskritanupranita Deshabhasha. Only if the Sanskrit Saraswati blesses the region languages, then such verse may come out. First, the translation I will read out. In scholarly assemblies, even a learned person's speech is unforthcoming. It acts like a newly married bride. When invoked, she does not say a word. When someone calls her, she does not step forward. Nahutapi purat padam rachayati. The word pada has two meanings. It is treading forward. Pura padam rachayati. Pada means foot. Param padam rachayati. Pada also means word. Even when the goddess Saraswati is invoked, she is unable to emerge out in the form of words. Praptopakantam hatar. She does not step forward when questioned. She gives no reply. Praptopakanta, upakanta means closer and also for an embrace. We are going to hug. She is unable to accommodate for that. She will not be available for a hug by the beloved. Praptopakantam hatat also means the words are choked in the throat itself. Praptopakantam hatat prishtana prabhivati. A newly married girl will not easily talk because of shyness. Praptopakantam hatat prishtana prabhivati. And even an untrained person cannot become sabhakavi. He will have difficulty in uttering words. Even though he knows so many things, he is unable to. Pravibhakti kampamayate. The girl is shuddering and he is also troubled, stage fear. And then stambham samalambati. Blank, mind goes blank. She trembles and freezes on the spot. And that happens with a sabhakavi who is not trained. Vaivaranyam swarabhanga manchati. She goes pale, vaivaranyam. And then her voice is choked and she can hardly speak, and if at all speaks, it will not be her voice. It will be a sneer. And in the case of a poet also, vaivaranyam, his words will lose one or the other alphabet or one or the other word. Swarabhangam, whether it is consonant or vowel, one or the other thing will miss out. Balan mandaksha mandanana. It's because of the shyness. It's because of the shyness. I'm unable to meet the task and I'm unable to meet the demand with that intention. So, kashtam bhoho pradibhavato abhisabham abhisabham. When a person is facing the sabha, that is a person who is sabha kavi bubhushu, kavi bubhushu, kashtam bhoho pradibhavato abhisabham vani na vodhayate. His vani Saraswati will act like a newly married girl. This way, sabha kavitva is not everyone's cup of tea, but one has to become. This purpose, the purpose of this present workshop is those who are kavis have to become sabha kavis, and those who are akavis, they have to become kavis, and those who are sabha kavis, they have to become avadhani, and those who are avadhanis, they have to become uttamottam avadhani. When they are ashtavadhani, they should become shatavadhani, something like that. It has a very ambitious goal. However, we do know the limitations of such endeavor, but this much should be at least taken care of. One and all should get the flavor of it, should get the feel of this art, so that when once we are conversant with the nature of art, the culture of art will naturally come by course of time, and we shall discuss all that. Please feel free, please be comfortable, please list out your questions whenever possible. Perhaps from tomorrow onwards, in every session, we shall devote a few minutes for discussions to save our time and to utilize the best of our time. List the questions and keep it prepared so that one after the other, the questions can be tackled. To that extent, the time can also be permitted. And on the last day, perhaps we'll be having even more time for total discussions. Well, if you have any doubt and if you feel anything which is wanting, if you need any other change of presentation, please suggest. Within my possible limitations, let me do more justice for you from different corners of the world and different corners of this great country have come. And more than anything, my very good friend Ramakrishna Pajataya is so enthusiastic and so committed to conduct this workshop. It is the will of good people which will never be made futile. Hope this will do. Thank you. Namaskar.